The Downtown Line, or DTL, is the fifth MRT line in Singapore. With a length of 42 kilometers and 35 stations, DTL is the longest MRT line in Singapore. Operated by SBS Transit, DTL was originally planned as three separate MRT lines that was combined into one. Why does DTL have a spiral in the middle unlike any other transit lines in the world? Let's take a ride underground and understand more of the unique shape of Downtown Line. Designed as a medium capacity, DTL is unique among MRT lines in Singapore and perhaps in the world. The line runs through residential areas in the northwest and east and perpendicularly meet near city and make a loop around Marina Bay. Today, the journey started at Bukit Panjang, the northern terminus of DTL. And listen carefully at the end of the safety announcement. In the Land Transport Authority or LTA white paper in 1996 and Urban Redevelopment Authority or URA concept plan 2001, there is no mention of DTL. Instead, the current DTL are the combination of three proposed rail lines. What are the events that caused the three separate rail lines to be combined as one? After the completion of original MRT lines of North-South Line or NSL and East-West Line or EWL, there are increasing interest to have more MRT stations in the other parts of Singapore. As the Central Business District or CBD extending south into reclaimed land of Marina Bay, there are need and requests to link the newly developed Marina Bay with the MRT. According to the Business Times newspaper dated 16th of October 1997, a new rail line called Marina Line has been proposed. The line will connect Kallang and Dhoby Ghaut with a branch from Marina Centre to People's Park, which is today Chinatown. Did you know that Marina Line was originally planned as LRT and not MRT? Lucky that they stick to MRT system as affirmed in the Straits Times newspaper article dated 7th of December 1998. It is unimaginable to think of the crowd after the Garden Rhapsody light, the light show at Gardens by the Bay, or after New Year's Eve or night after National Day Parade or NDP if LRT was chosen. DTL Stage 1 was originally planned as Downtown Extension or DTE, which was a branch of former Marina Line. DTE is an integral part of Downtown at Marina Bay development planning to reduce the car dependency. Original working station names are Millennia, Bayfront, Landmark, Cross Street and Chinatown. And if you notice, the working name is so different than the current station names. After public feedback, the current names for Stage 1 stations are Promenade, Bayfront, Downtown, Telok Ayer and Chinatown. DTL Stage 2 was planned as Bukit Timah Line or BTL, linking Bukit Panjang to the city via Bukit Timah. The route was planned to reduce the bus overcrowding and traffic congestion along Bukit Timah Road, Dern Arn Road and Upper Bukit Timah Road. In addition, journey between Bukit Panjang and city via LRT Bukit Panjang with transfers at Choa Chu Kang and Jurong East is long and cumbersome. I talked about Bukit Panjang LRT in the previous video where the LRT system is actually a people mover system that usually found between airport terminals. To understand more about Bukit Panjang LRT and the issues of this system, the link to watch this video is up here. arriving at Hume Station, opened at 28th of February 2025, located between Hillview and Beauty World. When DTL Stage 2 was constructed, Hume was built as a shell station and upgraded into a station as the surrounding areas start to develop. The opening of Hume Station is access to attractions such as former Ford Factory and Bukit Timah Summit. Bukit Timah in proper English is Timah Hill, not Bukit Timah Hill, because in Malay, Bukit means hill. Such Bukit Timah Hill is Timah Hill Hill, double hill. DTL Stage 3 was originally the northern part of Eastern Region Line or ERL, first mentioned on the 23rd of October 2001 when Dover Station was officially opened. Based on the LTM map from 2005, ERL would meet Downtown Extension or DTE in Chinatown, while BTL would meet Downtown Extension in Millennia, which is Studio Promenade. Originally planned as three separate MRT lines, one unfortunate event caused the MRT lines to be consolidated as one. On 20th of April 2004, part of MRT tunnel for Circle Line collapsed near Nicoll Highway and took away 4 lives and injured 3 others. After the incident, original Nicoll Highway MRT station was replaced by current Nicoll Highway station, south of the original station site. In URA Concept Plan 2001, Nicoll Highway station should become an interchange between Circle Line and another undisclosed MRT line. After the incident, Nicoll Highway only served Circle Line with an idle platform. On 27th of April 2007, Downtown Line project was announced with DTE, BTL and northern portion of ERL merged into a single MRT line. In LTA Community Handbook 2008, the completion date for Downtown Line was pushed forward from 2018 to 2016.
Why did the handbook use a Comic Sans font?
The estimated cost of DTL construction is 12 billion Singaporean dollars, fully automatic and fully underground. Downtown Line is named after Downtown Station, the only MRT line in Singapore named after a station. With its unique spiral alignment, Downtown Line was built by stages, Stage 1 and the spiral, Stage 2 and Stage 3. Stage 1 is the DTL alignment between Bugis and Chinatown, opened on 22nd of December 2013. The stage intersects with EWL at Bugis, Circle Line, CCL at Promenade and Bayfront, and NEL at Chinatown. Stage 1 serves dense commercial and business area and serves key tourist attractions in Singapore such as Marina Bay Sands and Gardens by the Bay. Stage 2 connects Bugis and Bukit Panjang, of which the stage was opened on 27th of December 2015. The alignment links city with Bukit Timah and directly links Bukit Panjang with the MRT system. The stage intersects with NEL at Little India, NSL at Newton, Thomson Eastcourt Line or TEL at Stevens and CCL at Botanic Gardens. Interestingly, there is no other station other than interchange stations between Little India and Botanic Gardens. Stage 3 between Chinatown to Expo was opened on 21st of October 2017. The stage links CBD with Eastern Townships and provides alternative route for passengers from Tampines, Expo and Changi Airport. The estimated final cost for this project is 20.7 billion Singaporean dollars. For some reasons, DTL did not intersect with each other at Rochor because due to nearness with Bugis Station, Rochor Canal above and North-South Corridor and SEA Underground, building a self-interchange station is a challenge on itself. To make sense of its nearness, walking duration between Rochor and Jalan Besar stations is just 8 minutes. In addition, some of the DTL interchanges are not even connected to the other line in a single pit zone. I will explain it in a moment. With a depth of 43 meters, Bencoolen is the deepest MRT station in Singapore. Let's see how long does it take to move from the platform to the surface. Bombardier Movia was chosen as the rolling stock with 3 carriages per set, half of number of carriages used in NSL, EWL and NEL. You might ask, why 3 and not just 6? Originally planned as 3 separate MRT lines, station on DTL Stage 1 is already made for 3 carriages before DTL was announced in the year 2007. If the number of carriages per set is more than 3, the cost of construction and maintenance will be higher, and so does the higher cost of land acquisition and higher operation costs if the actual number of passengers is below the forecast. Shorter trains mean shorter stations. Most stations can be squeezed into a tight space. The distance between Downtown Station, Telok Ayer Station and Chinatown Station is only 700 meters between each other, 10 minutes walking. Furthermore, unlike the station in NSL and EWL where focal stations are the front and center of the town planning, DTL stations were built in the townships that are maturely developed. Therefore, DTL is designed as a feeder line and alternative line while EWL remains the main line between the west and the east of Singapore. Regular users and visitors will notice how long and deep the walk from the entrance to the platform of certain DTL stations. Yes, including Bencoolen. According to LTA's Long-Term Master Plan or LTMP 2040, a joint internal study with LTA and the Ministry of Health, quote, the people living between 1 km and 2 km of a new Downtown Line 2 station lost more weight than the people who did not, likely due to the additional physical activity of travelling to and from the station. Thus, forget gym membership, using DTL regularly might be a good way to lose weight. Stopping at Bedok North for another mission that I explained in the previous video. I tried to find roti john served in Singapore that is so much different than what is served in Malaysia. Malaysians who visited the Lion City might be shocked if they order roti john and get a dish that is not the same as what they knew. To understand more about the roti john and who is Mr. John who makes the bread, the link to watch this video is up here. Please watch it, only 400 people so far. Arriving at Tampines Station, interchange station with EWL. But the thing is, interchange between DTL and EWL means step out. Exiting DTL station, walk in Tampines Bus Interchange, tap in, and entering Tampines EWL station. There is no direct paid link between DTL and EWL. This design where different lines have different platform that is not connected with the paid single zone is not only happened at Tampines. Newton and Bukit Panjang designed in a similar fashion where there is no paid link between the platform of different lines. Other than the high cost and difficulties to build a paid link between platforms, current ticketing system in Singapore public transport allow free transfer between rail to rail or rail to bus. Let's say you tap out, walk to another line, tap in again within 15 minutes, the journey is considered as a continuum and no additional charge incurred. Arriving at Expo, the current terminus of DTL. So what is the future of DTL? DTL3E will extend the line from Expo to Sungai Bedok with Shilin in between, scheduled to open by 2026. The extension will link DTL Stage 3 with TEL at Sungai Bedok, allowing direct access from Marine Parade to Tampines and Changi Airport. DTL2E extension from Bukit Panjang to Sungai Gadut is listed on LTMP 2040, where the extension will directly link Bukit Panjang with NSL at infield station of Sungai Gadut. As a conclusion, DTL has a unique spiral alignment due to amalgamation of three proposed rail lines into a single line, heavily used by the locals, while tourists might likely to use this line to go to Marina Bay and Chinatown. So what do you think about Downtown Line? You like it or not? You may comment below. If you want to ride Downtown Line, the line serves 35 stations from Bukit Panjang in Northwest to Expo in the East. The line connects inner part of Singapore such as Bukit Timah, Ubi and Bedok Reservoir with the city. There are many attractions throughout Downtown Line such as Bukit Timah and Ford Factory near Hume, Botanic Gardens, Gardens by the Bay, Lau Pasat near Teluk Ayer, Chinatown, National Museum near Bencoolen and Little India. Fare payment can be made using EasyLink, NETS, credit and debit card, both local and foreign cards, concession cards and Singapore Tourist Pass. No more cash for tickets. Reference list in the form of article is in the description for your further reference. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something new about Downtown Line as the most uniquely shaped MRT line in Singapore and perhaps in the world. Thank you so much for watching again and see you in the next video.